Factor 10 can be activated by reaction in either of two systems, in intrinsic factor or extrinsic factor. Means maybe inside the body, or if you are giving certain, or for example, you are injecting vitamin K, then the extrinsic factor system will stimulate. Intrinsic pathway, the initial reaction is conversion of the inactive factors 11 to 12 to activate factor 12A. Factor 12 is activated in vitro, means outside, by exposing blood to foreign surface glass test tube. It will take the blood in glass test tube, and factor 12 will be activated and converted into 12A. And that will help in the coagulation of the blood what you do in your lab test. Activation in vivo means body. Vitro means test tube. Activation in vivo occurs when the blood is exposed to collagen fibers underlying the endothelium in the blood vessel. When there is a release of the collagen fiber from the damaged tissue, then these factors will stimulate and help out. Here is intrinsic factor complete. Factor 12 and factor 10, and then you can see 8 and then 5. Then calcium role is there, then prothrombin role is there, and fibrinogen role is there. So there is a complete cascade, means complete procedure through which the blood coagulation will take place, and it will close the hole which is created in the damaged vessels. Extrinsic factor require contraction with tissue factors extended to the blood. This occurs when there is a trauma to the vascular wall and surrounding tissue. If you have got an injury in your hand or leg or anywhere in the body, then it will be stimulated. We call it extrinsic factor, means from the outside there is a stimulation, right? This occurs when there is a trauma to the vascular wall and surrounding tissue. Means if there is the external injury, the extrinsic factor is triggered by the release of the tissue, thromboplastin, from the damaged tissue, that activates factor 7. Means if there is an injury, then there is a stimulation of factor 7. The tissue, thromboplastin, and factor 7 activate factor 10. Means factor 7 will stimulate to the factor 10. So it's the continuity of the reaction. You can see here, tissue trauma means damage, tissue factors will stimulate 7, 7 will convert into 7A, then activate the 10th factor, then that and then factor will stimulate the prothrombin activator in the presence of calcium. Then they stimulate the thrombin, there is a thrombin formation, again there is requirement of calcium, right? So we need this whole procedure, we need certain things that is important, is certain proteins like fibrinogen, thromboxin, and prothrombin activators, platelet phospholipids and prothrombin. Platelet phospholipids convert to prothrombin, and prothrombin convert in the presence of calcium into the thrombin. Means this whole process help in the repair of the blood vessels. We call it cascade. Clot retraction, once the clot is formed, is to close the hole. Maybe it's a big, like you close the hole on the wall throwing a cement, but cement is scattered around and you have to clean those. So what you have to do, you have to, with your instrument, you have to remove the extra cement. In the same way, clot retraction will take place and that big clot will become small. Clot formation fully developed in 3 to 6 minutes. Contraction of platelet trapped within the clot, shearing the fibrin, meshwork, pulling the edge of the damaged vessels closer together. During clot retraction, serum is squeezed from the clot. Here is a figure of that. You can see the figure. injury to the wall of the blood vessel. Collagen is released from the blood vessel. That is, the phospholipid is also released. Tissue thromboplastin is there. Contraction of the vessel. First, we have seen the vessel contraction. Then temporary hemostatic plug is formed. At the same time, platelet reactions will take place. Activation of the coagulation. Another side activation. One side platelet reaction. Loose platelet aggregation. Platelet will accumulate at one place. Temporary plug will take place. Then then activation of coagulation. Prothrombin will convert into thrombin and limiting this reaction. Thrombohemorrhagic plug is formed. And then definitive hemorrhagic hemostatic plug. A complete plug is formed and close the hole. That is damage. This is damage. Anticoagulant mechanism means we were talking about the coagulation. Now anticoagulation mechanism. Once the clot is formed, then this clot has to be fulfilled. Fill the hole, close the vessels, and then remove the extra material which is present in the time of after the repairing of that vessel. Anticoagulant mechanisms are important in restricting clot formation to site of injury. Means this clot will not permanently remain over there. You have to fill it, and then automatically the body mechanism will close that hole. The two major systems are the anticoagulant and fibrinolytic system. Fibrinolytic means the mesh which is formed and close the plug. After certain time, that mesh has to be removed, and we call it fibrinolytic. Means lytic will break down of those fibrins which form the mesh or network. The anticoagulant system comprises four enzymes pathway whose function is to reduce the thromboxin. We have got only 10 more minutes and then we close this session. The anticoagulant system comprises four enzymes pathway function is reduce thromboxin production, limit its activity, or means the enzyme which is released from the wall of the blood vessels and from the platelet, like serotonin is coming from the platelet. Up to certain limit, they will release and they close the hole, and then again it stops. Plasma is the major enzyme of the fibrinolytic and will dissolve already formed clot by degrading fibrin. Now the clot is dissolved because it has filled the hole, closed the hole, and there is no requirement of that, and then this clot will dissolve, and then the hole is such close that it cannot be having a rough material. Disease of the anticoagulant system may be inherited or acquired as prediction of the event. Inherited disorder of the fibrinolytic systems are very rare. The clinician is more likely to encounter acquired hyperfibrinolysis that can cause severe hemorrhage. If these enzymes, after closing the damaged vessel, if it is with this phenomenon, if it will go into the fibrinolytic action, means remove the clotting which is active, and if it will continue, then maybe again it will damage the vessel and bleeding will start again. So we have to be very careful, that keep eye on that, and the body system should help out. Anticoagulant and antiplatelet drugs eliminate or reduce the site of risk of blood clotting. They are often called the blood thinner, but these medications do not really thin your blood. Instead, they help prevent or break up dangerous blood clot that form in your blood vessels or heart. means we can take certain medication like aspirin, which we call it a blood thinner. It doesn't mean a blood thinner, it help you the overclotting of those blood vessels, otherwise there is a plaque formation. So it will prevent. And forming your blood or heart without treatment, these clots can block your circulation and lead to a heart attack or stroke. You just think and make an imagination that your blood vessels from the inside, which is intima, is damaged, and that has been repaired through all the process we have just learned. And if there is excess accumulation of the blood platelet, there is a formation of the plug. And that plug can be removed due to the circulating blood. And if it is removed, then the embolism will go away from that damage, and that can occlude or block blood circulation to the vital organs or at the level of the capillaries. So we have to be very careful. For that, we give a blood thinner like aspirin. Both antiplatelet, means we do not allow the aggregation of the platelet, and anticoagulants work to prevent clot in your blood vessels, but they work in different ways. Means we, after certain, after the repair of the heart, we start certain medication on the patient, and we give loprin like a aspirin 75 milligrams as a prevention that excess clotting should not be take place and there is no thrombus formation which can occlude the blood circulation and can cause the lack of oxygen supply to the tissues, and in that way the tissues, those tissues will not work because they do not receive the blood supply. Antiplatelet interfere with the bleeding of the platelet or the process actually start the formation of the blood clot. So antiplatelet will interfere in the accumulation of the platelet, addition of the platelet to the wall of the vessel. So we have to be very careful while giving anticoagulant drugs. Anticoagulant interfere with the protein in your blood that are involved with the coagulation process. These proteins are called the factors. Different anticoagulants interfere with the different factors to prevent clotting. There are many anticoagulant drugs like heparin, which is an injectable form. We have got a warfarin, which is known as clomidin, from the DuPont USA, and rivaroxaban, dabigatran, apixaban, and these all drugs, which is all are anticoagulant drugs. Common antiplatelet includes the clopidogrel, which is one of the anticoagulant like aspirin, then ticagrelor, lasergel, dipyridamole, aspirin, teclopidine, and eptifibatide. These are all antiplatelet, means do not allow accumulation of the platelet. Right, this is all about today's lecture that we have learned heart failure. We have learned the coronary artery diseases physiology. We have learned the hemostasis, how the bleeding stops. What are the external factors? What are the internal factors? Right? So next topic of our class will be respiratory system. So here I am stopping this, closing this lecture, because the time is over, then I have to go again into the connection. And that is all also not record, difficult to record on the YouTube if it is more than 40 minutes. So I have to stop over there. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Hello. 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 आवाज आ रही है?
Yes, sir.
अच्छा अब हमारा अब मेरे ख्याल से नेक्स्ट क्लास हमारी शायद वहां पे होगी, क्योंकि 15 से यूनिवर्सिटी खुल रही है.
जी नहीं सर, लेकिन कल भी क्लास है ना.
हाँ कल तो आपकी क्लास होगी. मैं नेक्स्ट वीक की बात कर रहा था कि वो जरा देख लेंगे.
नेक्स्ट वीक क्लास
नेटफ्लिक्स की क्लास का, और ये एक्चुअली ये अटेंडिंग शॉट लेके अगर आप उनको हिना को भिजवा देना तो बच्चा होगा कि वो मुझे कल फोन कर रही थी, इसके इसके स्क्रीन शॉट ले लें आप, अटेंडेंस आ रही है ना सामने।
अच्छा
हाँ, आप जो है ना पार्टिसिपेंट पे, पार्टिसिपेंट पे जाएंगे ना तो स्क्रीन शॉट ले लें, स्क्रीन शॉट लेके ना हिना को भिजवा दीजिएगा, क्योंकि वो मुझसे लीक मांगती रहती है। हाँ, और उस पर डेट वगैरह डाल दीजिएगा, टाइमिंग डाल दीजिएगा, डेट कम से कम डेट डाल दीजिएगा, ठीक है। ओके, अल्लाह हाफिज़।